Hello, my name is Rodrigo Martinez, and welcome to Praying with Art. Today I am here at St. James Catholic Church in Stoughton. We'll be looking at some stained glass windows and at the unique mosaic located at what is properly called the apse of the church, usually where the altar of sacrifice is located. Scripture tells us that St. James was the brother of John the Evangelist, and the two were called by Jesus as they worked with their father in a fishing boat on the Sea of Galilee. From that point on, Jesus was the focus of James' life, and it is also evident that James held a special place in Jesus' life as well. St. James the Apostle is one of the three disciples that made up the inner circle of Jesus' disciples, along with John and Peter. St. James witnessed the Transfiguration, a major event in Jesus' revelation as the Son of God, and the agony in the garden, where Jesus' full humanity is on display. We can say that St. James truly knew his Lord, his full humanity, and his full divinity. Acts of the Apostles tells us that St. James was the first apostle to be martyred in Jerusalem, some 11 years after the resurrection. King Herod Agrippa beheaded him in an attempt to halt the spread of Christianity. There's a story that the man who arrested James became a convert after hearing James speak at his trial, and was executed with the apostle as well. Legends have sprung up that St. James evangelized Spain before he died, but it's unclear he ever visited the area. Notwithstanding, St. James is beloved in Spain, and one true story might have contributed to this devotion. It is said that after his death, St. James' relics were taken by ship to Spain. As it approached the coast of Portugal, a man was riding his horse on the beach. The horse disobediently plunged into the sea with its rider, making for the boat. They sank, of course, but then rose again, covered with scallop shells, and hence the cockless shell became the symbol of St. James. The relics were entombed and forgotten during years of Roman persecution, invasions, and Muslim attacks. That is, until an early 9th century hermit, Pelagius, who discovered the tomb. Later, a cathedral was built to mark the location. The faithful began to make pilgrimage to the site, so much so that Compostela in northern Spain became the third greatest place of pilgrimage, just after Jerusalem and Rome. After making one of the many routes known as El Camino, the Way, pilgrims attach cockshells found along the trail to their hats or clothes as signs that they had venerated the holy relics. The scallop shells also act as a metaphor. The grooves in the shell, which meet at a single point, represent the various routes pilgrims traveled, eventually arriving at a single destination, the tomb of St. James in Santiago de Compostela. At the time of the Moorish invasions, a particular battle took place that was to seal St. James ever more closely to Spain, where he is known as Santiago. In 841 AD, the Christians had lost a battle and were in retreat when the king had a dream in which St. James assured him of victory. The next morning, when called to battle, the men saw before them St. James on a horse adorned with cockless shells, waving a banner. He led the Christians to a clear victory, and ever since, the Spanish battle cry has been Santiago. Because of the love the Spanish have for St. James, they adopted him as their patron, and his feast is a national holiday, a time of great celebration, much like the feast of St. Patrick is for the Irish, and that of St. Joseph for the Italians. St. James is the patron saint of pilgrims and soldiers. He is usually depicted in art with his symbols, the cockle shell, pilgrim hat, sword, sacred scripture, or on a horseback. Now, let us look at the unique mosaic we have here at St. James Church in Stoughton. Here we see Christ in the center, surrounded by six angels who are offering him honor and praise, with their hands locked in front of their chest to symbolize worship and service. We can see Jesus with his right hand over his chest and the left extended downwards, symbolizing his rightful justice being poured out to us as mercy through his left hand. From both hands and feet, we see rays coming out of the nail marks, which symbolize his life-giving graces, flowing out from his wounds, which were caused by death, which were caused by our sin. Jesus, the Alpha and the Omega, conquered death to give us life. Amen.